By the end of this video, you'll understand what primitive obsession is, why it's secretly sabotaging your code, and most importantly, how to kick it to the curb, clean code style. Imagine a world where developers refuse to use anything other than the basic data types, strings, ints, booleans. That's it. No custom classes, no structured types, just raw primitives everywhere. So in this world, you're tasked with building an e-commerce app. You've got customer addresses, product information, orders, and all sorts of juicy details to manage. But you're told you can only use strings, integers, and booleans. That's like being asked to build a Lego Millennium Falcon, but you only have square bricks. So what do? You start storing addresses as strings, like you smush street names, city names, zip codes, everything into one long string. Easy, right? But then your boss comes along and says, "Hey, can you validate that the city name is in a specific format? Wait. Now you gotta manually parse this monster string every time just to find the city name. And if someone decides to input their entire life story instead of just their street address, good luck. Things start spiraling. Your app needs to calculate discounts based on product types, but again, you're only allowed to use integers. So you start making a bunch of magic numbers like one for electronics and two for clothing. Suddenly the code is full of these cryptic values that only you can understand because, well, you made them up. Fast forward a few months, you get an urgent call while sipping your fifth coffee of the day. The new intern accidentally mixed up the numbers, and now people are getting discounts on luxury yachts instead of socks. Oops. At this point, your code looks like a bowl of spaghetti. You realize, maybe, just maybe, it's time to get some structure in here. But in this world, there's no such thing as classes or structured types. You're stuck. You're trapped in a nightmare of your own making, all because you kept everything as primitive types. And that's where we leave this world. A developer hunched over their keyboard, desperately trying to unravel the mess they've created. Why? Because they couldn't break free from primitive obsession. Now, let's talk about how this really plays out in the real world and how you can actually fix it. You're back in your actual project, and you just spotted the code equivalent of a ticking time bomb, primitive obsession. You see addresses stored as strings, prototype has integers, and flags all over the place. It's time to fix this mess before it becomes the code equivalent of a house of cards. Primitive obsession is when you overuse basic data types. Ints, strings, booleans, instead of creating your own more meaningful types. And at first it seems like, oh, I'll just store the phone number as a string. It's no big deal. But is it a big deal? Why? Because now every time you need to do something with that phone number, like format it, validate it, or use it in any other context, you have to manually parse that string. And you know what that leads to? Repetition, inconsistent logic, bugs. You start poking around and realize it's not just phone numbers. You've got booleans like isActive, hasPermissions, isAdmin, and a dozen more sprinkled everywhere. Or worst, you've got magic numbers like 0, 1, and 2 representing statuses. 0 means pending, 1 means approved, 2 means rejected. Makes sense today, but will it in 6 months when you've forgotten what 2 even stands for? The code base becomes hard to read and worse, hard to maintain. Every time you add a new feature, you're terrified you'll break something. Why? Because everything's tied together with fragile primitive strings and numbers. It's like trying to run a city using just street names and building numbers without any zoning laws. Total chaos. Here's the light bulb moment. Instead of using primitives everywhere, you start creating small, focused classes or types. You build an address class that holds the street, city, and zip code. You create an order status enum instead of relying on random integers. And for all these booleans, you replace them with proper objects that encapsulate behavior, like an admin user class that knows exactly what permission it has. Suddenly, the code becomes easier to read. You know what's what because everything's got a name and a purpose. No more guessing what one means in a status update function or trying to parse out city names from giant strings. And best of all, if you need to change the format of addresses or add a new product type, you know exactly where to do it because it's not just scattered throughout your code base. This approach where you create more specific meaningful types is the cure for primitive obsession. It's all about encapsulating the logic and validation that comes with these values directly inside new structures. The code becomes way more readable, and the logic gets centralized. Instead of hunting down every place you've used an address string, you just update the methods in your address class. Done. Primitive obsession might seem harmless at first, but it can seriously mess with your code's clarity, maintainability, and sanity, yours included. By moving away from using plain old primitives and creating meaningful types that carry behavior and context, you make your code base way more robust and easier to work with. It's like going from a cluttered toolbox full of random screws and nails to a neatly organized one where everything has its place. Next time you see a string that's really an address or an integer that's pretending to be a product type, ask yourself, am I getting too obsessed with primitives? Then break free.